That's absolutely right, and that's why I love your job 100%, that this shows that there's a lot more investigation. And I agree with Mimi that Giuliani's comments are absurd, because this has been one of the most disciplined and relentless federal criminal investigations I've ever seen. These people do not leak, and Mike Flynn's lawyers were not leaking, so there is no way that Giuliani or anybody in the Trump team knows what Mike Flynn has given them. It could be substantial, and let's not forget, Mike Flynn was on board with the idea of a rapprochement with Russia. He was obsessed with radical Islam. He believed that you could team up with Russia to fight that threat. He had many conversations with Donald Trump on this subject, and he was aware of meetings that were taking place between the Trump team and the Russians. And here's what else he knows why he decided to lie about his own interaction with the Russian ambassador, even though he wasn't.
Fully, truthfully, and completely, and is still doing that, and is getting and then you can be sentenced to additional time. And the other thing is, remember, you know, Giuliani and Trump and everybody, there was for a while even this theory out there that, you know, Flynn hadn't really lied. This was all a big trap. Well, I mean, look at this, right? You don't have this kind of sentencing letter from the government, this kind of report back for, you know, for a big trap as that Giuliani and Trump keep trying to talk about, right? Flynn came clean here. He admitted that he lied because he got caught. And I think he cooperated so quickly, in part because he probably got caught really red-handed in a way that he could not deny. So, you know, once again, I think it's important to point out when Mueller speaks and puts the lie to things that Trump and Giuliani and others, surrogates, go out there and just say with no evidence whatsoever.
John Hyland reminded us of how much time Michael Flynn spent with candidate Donald Trump during the presidential campaign. And who can forget Michael Flynn's appearance at the Republican National Convention? I think we have some ready to go. This is the night to look at this one more time. Discussion now, Democratic Congressman Jerry Nadler of New York City. He is the ranking member of the House Judiciary Committee. He will become the chairman of the Judiciary Committee in the House of Representatives in January. Congressman Nadler, I just want to get a reaction. I'm sure you saw as it happened during the Republican convention. You were talking about the candidate you were supporting for president. Your feelings, when you saw that night, an unprecedented moment, I think, in the history of our political conventions, someone out there on a convention stage saying the other candidate should be locked up, and this candidate tonight getting the recommendation from a special prosecutor that he not be locked up.
Well, my reaction when I saw that was that, oh my God, you've got a candidate and a spokesman for a candidate who have lost all sight of American traditions and a democratic tradition, and who try to make enemies of their opponents, and use the power of, and threaten to use the power of law for political purposes, and that is very dangerous. And of course, we now know that this president lies incessantly about everything. And one thing I think we know now is that his period of being able to lie incessantly and not being called to account is coming to an end, both because of the Mueller investigation, because of what they're revealing, because the fact that at least one House of Congress is now going to do a proper job of holding him accountable.
The reactions tonight in the special prosecutor's filing are the things that we're all fascinated by. I'm sure that the House Judiciary Committee will be equally fascinated, and that your staff will be studying these documents tonight. And how will you approach, as you take the chairmanship next year, information like this that becomes public, that is of public interest, and yet is being held back by the special prosecutor? You have a competing interest that I suppose you want, in some sense, make a cooperating interest at some time with the special prosecutor. How do you handle that going?
I think our first duty is to protect the integrity of the special counsel's investigation, and we're not going to do anything knowingly that we that investigation. We would certainly, before doing certain things, consult with them to say, to make sure we're not, by accident, stepping on the investigation in any way, because we are dependent on that investigation.